We will open the project. It's here. Then we can look around inside our project. We will use the open the user application, the main.c, what is changed. Now, definitely here is still the HL underscore init. It must be there. Again, the system clock config is also here. Because we're using the GPIOs, they are still here, the GPIO init. But what is new? We have here the USART init. First I need to compile to allow me to use go to definition specific for Kyle. Okay, can I go into init? But we can see we have here using the handle from the USART, and we putting here the instance that it's we want to use this for the USART too, and we init this handle structure with the baud rate and all the parameters that we set, and then we calling again the USART init. As you remember from the MSP section, then if we call the init function, it is possible to create the MSP callback. The CubeMX using this MSP callback also. Then here, if we go here to the HL MSP, then we can find here that is the HL underscore UART underscore MSP init. And we have here some initialization. Then why we need to initialize something else from the UART? Or the UART, because we also, for example, using the GPIO with the USART, which are related to this payframe, then we, CubeMX, usually create the initialization for the related pins in the MSP file. And you can see, first he checking which instance call this MSP init, he checking that is USART2, which is our own. If it's USART2, he automatically enables the clock. This is also necessary. If you remember, we need first time to enable the clock, and then we can configure the periphery also. And then he also configured the pins because they are related to this periphery. Then this is the init. The something which is new here is here this handle. We used the structure in the GPIOs, but it was local structure. Now this handles for the communication peripheries and the other peripheries is as a global. In this handle, we store all the information which we need for the working with this periphery. Definitely here, it's identification of the periphery, that is USART2. It's not USART1, it's not USART2, we want USART1. There are also parameters which we need to set, but in this handle is many more things. It's usually written there how many bytes we will want to select, if somebody used this periphery or not. And the other information like if we're using the DMA or what is the link between the DMA. About this a little bit later. But this handle is usually it's defined as a global, and we can find this handle here. The handle is necessary in case that we want to operate with this payphrase. We definitely need to use the handle. Then we can try. As usually, if we want to work with the payphrase, we start with the word HL. We start with the name of the payphrase, but I will want to work with this payphrase as a UART because I not enable the synchronous mode. Then the UART. It's okay, and then is the name of the function. For the communication peripheries, we have definitely init. The init is the standard for the all HL functions, but for the communication, usually using the words for the like the transmit or receive. Then here is also this function with the same name, one for the receive with the interrupt, with the DMA, not only the receive with the software, and also here will be the transmit function with the DMA or with the interrupt. And first I will use the transmit function. Then what to put here as the parameters? I can here use the go to definition. You can see I am in the file stm32f4x6_hl_uart.c, and I can here found all the parameters. The first parameter is the pointer to our handle, which we know that is defined as the global. Second parameter is the pointer on the buffer which we want to send. Then is the how many bytes we want to send. And then is the timeout. Because the transmit is the blocking function, we sending the data with the software. Then we also need to define the timeout after. If this timeout is reached, we end this function with the timeout. Then first parameter, put here the handle. I can here copy the name. It's usually starting handle generated with the grouping starting with the H and then name of the periphery, in our case UART2. Then I here put the H UART2, you can advise me, but we want the pointer. Be careful, I here need to put the end symbol. Then second parameter is the buffer. Then for this I need to create the buffer. Then here I will define my buffer. It will be 8-bit buffer unsigned. Okay, here put the buffer, for example, with 10 variables. And to recognize this variables, I initialize this buffer with the numbers. Okay, I initialize my buffer. It's perfect. It's called buffer. Then I can put here the buffer. Third parameter is the how many bytes I want to send. It's the 10. And the last parameter is the timeout. I'm not expecting here the timeout problems with the transmitting, but I have here put the 100 milliseconds. Why not? Then I compile my code. And I can go into the debug. I think it's okay. Now I sending the data, and now how to receive this? Definitely, first of all, I need to discover which COM port is my USART. Then for this, I open the device manager. In the device manager, I will go here into the ports, the COM or LPT, and I'm searching for the STM Microelectronics Stealing Virtual COM port, which is here. And you can see in my case, the number is 35. Usually the COM port, the STLink, depends how many times you connect the STLink COM port. I'm usually on very, very high number now. Then I need to use the terminal. I'm using, for this case, the real term, which allow me to use all the COM ports which the Windows can handle. Then here I have the display. I will want to display the hex and also the ASCII part, and in the port I search for the COM port 35, it's the USB, and I need to set the correct baud rate, which is 115,200, no parity, 8-bit data, 1-stop bit. This is what I sent. Then I enable the COM port, and now here I run my program. Sorry, I maybe forget to put here the delay because it will be so fast, but I can try. I run my program. You can see it's a little bit fast, but my terminal is serving this speed. And it seems that it's working. We are receiving the data which we are sending. Then this part is okay. I have no problems with this. Definitely here I also want to talk a little bit about the function. The lot of the HL functions also supporting returning the parameters. I'm not handling here the return parameter because for the hands-ons it's not necessary, but I recommend you to always, when you call the function, check also the parameters which the function gives you back. And here you can see that this returning parameter, the status type def. I can define this parameter in my project. Some return variable, and I can always get the information what's happened with this my hands-on. Okay, I let him run, then I stop. Oh, sorry, it seems that my code is too optimized for this. Then he sometimes cut some part of the code. Then here in the Kyle, I change the optimization here in the project option. Here in C++ is the optimization, and here change it to 0. This allows me to fully debug the code, because with the high optimization he usually try to delete unused part of my code. In my case it will be possibly the return value, because it's wasting for him. He discovered that I'm not using this value, but I want this value for the debugging. This means here I order the code. And be careful on the optimization. Okay. Can debug this multiple time, and I can look on this variable in my watch what is the state, and here return me the hull. Okay, this is perfect. But here I can return more. You can look here into definition of this variable. You can return okay, error. This will be important that he is busy, that something, the transmission is in progress. And also he can return the timeout. Then for you, for the better safety of your code, it's good to use these callbacks. Okay, now we know how to send the data, but we also want to receive the data. Then I can here put the reception. I can start with the HL. What? It will be received again. Again the pooling mode. This means it's again blocking function. Then if I transmitting, I'm block here. If I'm receiving here, I'm also block here for the timeout time. And I here put that I will send 10 bytes. And then I want to receive something. For this I will create the new buffer. It's gonna be empty. Ah, so it's the same name, then buffer 2, why not? Okay, I receive buffer 2. I want to receive 10 bytes, and my timeout will be, I think, very long, because I need to do this all manually. Then I think I put here the 100 second, 1000 second. I think it's okay. Now, and when I receive the data, I will stop here on my breakpoint. In case that you have, or I can put here the while one, to be sure that I receive only one buffer, for example, to block me here. I can put here the breakpoint, and we can see what will happen. Sorry, maybe it will be also good here, use the return value also for my receiving to see what will happen in case that we time out the function. And now I will go to the debug, I run my code, and now in the terminal I can try to write something. Okay. We'll see where I am. Still in the receive, but I'm not receiving anything. It's a bit strange. Why not? Ah, because my part is closed. Sorry. I need to open here my closed. Ah, it seems that my transmitting. Oh. Function is not working, sorry. Then again, I think it will be the best. I start the sending and transmitting. Here for sure I will clear my window. Not blaming. I will mark him to show me which bytes I'm receiving and I am sending. This is prepared. I run my code. You can see here we sent the 10 bytes. Now I try to write him something back. Ah, I get the interrupt. You can see I received the 10 bytes, and we can look into my watch. What I received here in my buffer. You can see if I compare this with my terminal, the 71, 0, 77, yes, 65, 72, it fits perfect, and the return value, it's okay. But now I can, for example, the short this delay on the 100 milliseconds. I will be not capable to send the bytes in the 100 millisecond after I start this project. Okay, I can run it, and you can see I immediately stopped. Here I'm return for me that the timeout. Then don't forget to get this information from use the return variables. Also, this functions, the pooling functions are blocking. Then I can only transmit or only receive in the same time. It's really limited my possibilities, because then the USART is useless. I cannot do the both in the same time. Then for this, I need to use the interrupt or the DMA. About this, we will talk a little bit later in the next hands-on.